All right, the first thing we want to do when we are embarking on a mapping expedition, if you will, we want to make sure that we have our Lowrance display set up correctly. Here you can see this is the home page where all the different screens are. The top priority we're going to want to have and what we're going to watch while we're mapping is we want to have the chart and at least the sonar. So here we're going to touch the chart and sonar screen option. So here we see our chart on our left, the sonar on our right. Now you can see there's various digital displays. These screens, they may have some defaults that, you know, they might show your depth, they might show your speed over ground. So what you do is you hit the power button once. This is going to give you the option to edit overlay. And here's the options for adding different displays, different digital readouts. Go to add. I want to make sure on sonar that I have my depth checked. That's checked. Got my water temperature. We have the chart on the left, and then we have our sonar screens on the right. We have two sonar frequencies running here. We have the 200 kilohertz. 200 kilohertz is also known as broadband. It's a sonar beam that's like a flashlight beam. And then we also have our downscan. You might also hear it be called structure scan. That is a narrow elliptical beam, almost like a copy machine scanner. And that is scanning the bottom. It's getting a different view of the bottom, different view of the vegetation. Sometimes you get a little better resolution here, and you can kind of see that. You can see that difference between the broadband, the traditional, you know, almost like a flashlight beam sonar, and then the real narrow beam, and almost like a ultrasound. BioBase is going to take both frequencies and it will create a map of the vegetation using both the traditional sonar frequency and also the downscan frequency as well. 0.1 GPS, it'll give you a little more situational awareness, a little better positioning, and perhaps in some cases a little better accuracy and more precision on where that GPS position is lined up. So this is your X and Y position. The transducer is your Z position. The transducer is back in the back of the boat. So the 0.1 GPS is gonna allow that X, Y, and Z positions to all be lined up. And then we wanna put a depth line in here. Now it's kinda hard to see, and you'll see it as we get going through aquatic vegetation, but you want to be able to see where is that depth being recorded. The depth, that's that 37.9, is right where this yellow stops. And you can, there's actually a black line that's hard to see, but you have to add that, and you do that through more options, and you add the depth line. So now that we got our screens all set up, I'm gonna take you through a little demonstration on how we actually collect some sonar data. I'm gonna take you through a little trip around in this little bay, and we're gonna map this little bay here first, and then I'll demonstrate some transect design and data collection techniques, a few tips and tricks. So now we're actively mapping here, and you can see the path I'm going around the lake. The speed is at 1.4 miles an hour, so anything greater than 6-7 miles an hour, if you're mapping complex habitats, you're gonna lose some accuracy and resolution. So try to keep your speed anywhere less than 7 miles an hour. Unless you're mapping wide open expanses where it's just, there's just not much structure or vegetation, just a flat bottom. In those cases you can go, well, I think the limits are up to 20 miles an hour. But as you can see here, this is not a flat bottom. It's complex. You can see there's a lot of, there's vegetation growing in different lengths, and our objective for this demo run is to show you the aquatic vegetation mapping. And I also want to show you on this screen that here's that depth line. That depth line is going to be important to display so you can kind of see where depth is tracking. you're going to want to keep an eye on that digital depth display. Sometimes in really dense vegetation, you get a loss of depth. If that depth is flashing, or if it's just showing, you know, three dashes, it's not recording depth, it's not recording information. So you're going to want to stop, you're going to want to reacquire bottom, and then you're going to want to get that depth back. So the goal we're going for here is to produce the most smooth bathymetric or contour map, and a strategy or tactic to use to create the smoothest bathymetric chart is to follow the contours. And so that's what we're doing here, but we also want to map the aquatic vegetation, and we want to make sure that we are hitting the edge of that aquatic vegetation growth. So we're going to take a couple trips. We're going to do this concentric circle design. We also want to make sure that we're always hitting the edge of the vegetation growth. So right here, you can see it's quite deep. It's a pretty steep shore, but now I'm going to go in a little bit, but there is aquatic vegetation, as you can see up here. And you can see that now on the display here. So we want to make sure that we are hitting that edge. So here you can see a clear bottom line through the vegetation on the both the traditional, the broadband on the top, and then the structure scan on the bottom. Everything above that dark line there is aquatic vegetation. It should stop around 17, 18 feet. So we're just kind of doing a slow weave in and out of the vegetation. The key thing is to maintain a slow speed whenever you're going over areas of large change. There's the vegetation edge there, and we went out of the vegetation. Now we're coming back into the vegetation. So we're just kind of slowly weaving in and out. So now we're gonna do a different transect pattern. We're gonna do kind of some back and forth passes. In some cases, that kind of mapping might be preferable in order to get kind of a cross-section look at the bottom and where exactly that vegetation edge is occurring. But I've already set up the transect pattern. It's a route that I created. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn that route on. Show. Turn it on. Okay. We're gonna exit out of there. There's our route. Depending on how large a lake is, you're gonna adjust your transect spacing accordingly. But here, for this demonstration purpose, we have 125 foot passes we're gonna do. And I'm gonna start recording my sonar. SL2. Record. And now, I'm gonna start following these lines. Once I get a straight path, I'm gonna take landmarks on shore and use those landmarks on shore to keep me straight. You can see we're starting to come up the slope here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start slowing down, because we don't wanna make anywhere where the bottom is changing quickly, we want that to be slow. So now we're pretty straight, and I'm gonna need to turn this. I'm gonna need to turn the boat now. And the thing that we want to do is make a nice square turn. And you know, a lot of times I don't even look at my transect lines when I'm doing this. I wanna make a nice crisp turn, which I'm doing now. And what I'm gonna do is now I'm gonna look at the disturbance from my prop. So we want to look at our trail of bubbles behind the motor, because that, especially if you had a straight shot before you made the turn, that's gonna tell you. You just basically line the boat up with that bubble trail, and you will be straight every time. And then you look down at your display and at the transect lines and just verify that, you know, one way or the other that you're lined up. The course and heading line helps you, is another guide to help you stay straight on your path. Here you can see we're going over a midwater hump. There's actually fish. These are trees, so you can see there's actually fish in these trees. So now we're at the end of the trip. So we're just gonna stop recording. Here you can see that was a 10 minute elapsed time, 161 megabytes, hit stop. And we're done. So there you have it. Now we've recorded some nice tracks over vegetation, over deep areas, over a wide variety of habitats. We got our map done. So we're going to stop recording. We've got everything logged onto our SD card. We're gonna now take this back into the office and we're gonna upload it to BioBase and we'll take a look at the outputs there.